The Bible says in Proverbs 29, where no vision, the people perish. But he that keepeth the law, happy he. And this is a real life example of how people are perishing. But before we get into what I just showed you, I want to let you know, if you didn't know already, that one of the things I believe I'm supposed to do is literally write, whether that be writing books, whether that be writing articles in magazines, or writing articles on our website. Today, I published one book called Walk in the Spirit. In 2010, this is the book that got published. And this book here specifically, I believe God gave me the vision of what the book was going to be about. I believe he gave me the vision of what the book was going to be called. And ultimately, I believe God gave me the vision of what the book would actually look like, the front cover. And not long after, the first book I wrote called Walk in the Spirit became a reality. And in more recent years, most people are going to see this book right here. It's the same book, Walk in the Spirit. I'll post a link in the description box below to our website if you want to see where I do most of my writing. And I'll also post a link in the description box below to a book that I've written that I'm about to talk about if you want to support me that way. Now, for those of you who want to support me in that way financially, thank you in advance. But at the same time, if you don't want to support me financially by getting a copy of my book, or if you just can't support me one way or another financially, I've also posted a link in the description box below for you to get a copy of my book for free. Whatever option you take going forward, I hope it blesses you either way anyway. But let me explain how we got to this instead of this. Now, up until this point in my life, I'm not the best artist in the world. It's actually quite the opposite. But I believe God gave me a concept that I could literally draw down in my own kind of way and literally give to someone else to basically make it a reality. So what you can see right now is you can actually see the papers that I actually drew on, where I believe God was showing me what it was supposed to look like. Now, the fact of the matter is, what I envisioned all those years ago was literally a guy literally leaving the flesh and walking into this house, which was a representation of the spirit. And when you look at these two books, which one of these books depicts what I just explained to you and what you saw in the terrible attempts at drawing this? Let me know in the comment section below what you think. But the point is, the first time I tried to attempt this, the content of the material is pretty much largely the same. But the fact of the matter is, I had basically went with this publisher that was supposed to help me, and really and truly, they didn't really care too much about what my vision was. I literally showed them the drawings I've actually shown you. I wrote out a long brief, and this is basically what they came back with. Basically, just a simple cut and paste stock image with some basic font for a title. And they said, look, this is your book. Now, back then, I wasn't bold enough to make the right decision. I kind of just followed through with it, because at the end of the day, I said, you know what? At the end of the day, it's better to just produce something and have it out there than to not have it at all. But in this particular scenario, why would God give me the vision if there was no point in me actually doing it? Case in point, this is why years later, I basically made the decision, said, you know what? This is what the vision actually looked like. Let me focus on doing this and actually not focusing on the other one. So the link I'm going to post in the description box below is going to be to get this copy of the book. You see, people can actually slow themselves down, even if they have a vision, if they don't actually follow what the vision actually says. So think about this. In 2010 is when that first book got published. But it was only pretty much in the last couple of years where I recalibrated, where I refocused myself, got back on point and said, you know what? Let me do this the way I believe God was showing it to me in the beginning. This is powerful, because I was talking to my brother literally a couple of days ago, and he was literally showing me this card, this note, which literally had a list of a couple of things he believed he was supposed to do. And he wrote this down in 2017. And I was basically encouraging him. I was saying, look, the fact of the matter is, it's been a few years now and you haven't actioned out these things that you've written down on this card. But don't let us have a conversation in another 3 years, another 4 years, God willing, and you basically be saying, look, this is the card I showed you 3-4 years ago, and 3 or 4 more years have gone now, and it's exactly the same thing. Well, it's not even exactly the same thing, it's even worse. And when you think about it like that, the vision that I actually had 10 years ago was not executed in the right way. Why? Because I allowed just things in life to basically get in the way of what I truly believed and saw. So we're talking about literally 6 or 7 years of the vision basically perishing. And ultimately, in the end, it finally came to fruition. But think about all of the impact I could have had 6 or 7 years prior if I just focused more on what God actually wanted me to do and not just what fear got me to do ultimately in the end anyway. Now, what I was showing you right here is literally the second book I wrote in 2010/2011. But the question I ask is, where is it? This is a note from the 7th of January 2012, and it's an image of what the book cover should actually look like. But the fact of the matter is, years later today, as I record this video, nothing has changed. It's still literally written in this journal of mine from 8 years ago. You see, the point I was trying to make is, who isn't to say, because of the drawbacks I allowed myself to go through in regards to the first book, not in having the book in the vision the way I wanted it to, that it didn't dishearten me in regards to the second book I wrote not long after, basically showing me, or at least like in my mind, at least saying to myself, you know what? You don't want to go through with this book, because what's going to happen is the same thing that happened with the first book. You've got this cover, but at the same time, you're going to go with someone and they're basically going to say, look, this isn't how the book's going to look. This is how the book's going to look. And you're not strong enough to basically make the right decision. The fact is, I had a vision and I was fumbling in regards to this vision. And it basically ultimately, as you can see now, turned into a snowball effect. So we're talking about going back to 2012 at the latest, at least, where I literally had the book written. I had the book cover. And up until this point, it's still just there in the journal. There was no vision that I was actively looking at daily, and the vision perished. And the more and more I ignore these things and allow these things to perish, one day soon after, I may perish and be someone that literally buried most of my talents in the ground and never actually utilized them. So what to do going forward? I'll tell you what I've done so far in a couple of days since. I've spoken to someone already that I know about designing a book cover. I've spoken to someone already that I know about literally making the layout of the book look nice. I need to publish this book. I'm telling you so you can support me in any way you can. Hold me accountable and help me complete this vision. I do not want you to make the same mistakes that I've been making. Now, this has all been about perishing due to a lack of vision, whether you have a vision or whether you bury your vision in a journal that you only pick up periodically. If you want help learning how to start your calling or complete your vision, I recommend you watch this video right here. It's a great video that's going to show you exactly how to do it. Thanks and take care, and I'll see you on the next video.